My dear students, now I want to discuss some important theorems involving adjointed. These theorems are very, very important for the purpose of solving multiple type of questions. Theorem 1. If A be any given square matrix of order n, then A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A is equal to mod A into I, where I is the identity matrix of order. Now, what is theorem 1? If A be any given square matrix of order n, then A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A is equal to mod A, that is not mod A, determinant A into I, where I is the identity matrix of order. For verification, let us consider A is a matrix having the small elements A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. And adjoint A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. This is the cofactors of the corresponding elements of the matrix. Then, since A and adjoint A are both square matrices of the same order n by n, therefore both A into adjoint A and adjoint A into A exist and are of the same order n by n. Now, A into adjoint A, ij is equal to, now you want to find the product of A matrix A which is adjoint A. Then, we will get here the multiplication of two matrix. First, matrix is matrix A, and we take ith and rth element of this matrix, and adjoint of matrix rth and jth element. So it will give you ir. So r is equal to 1 to n air CRJ. So if we multiply the matrix elements of matrix to its corresponding cofactors, then we will get this result. We will get determinant of the matrix if I is equal to J. Means diagonal elements will be determinant and non-diagonal elements will be zero. If we take the products of a matrix with its adjoint, then we will get diagonal matrix will be determinant A and non-diagonal will be zero. So A into adjoint A is equal to determinant A 0, 0, 0, 0 determinant A 0, 0, 0, 0 determinant A. So in this way, A into adjoint A is equal to determinant A and identity matrix of, if you take common determinant A, then it will be identity matrix of order n. Similarly, we can obtain adjoint A into A is equal to determinant A into I. So we will get very important result. A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A is equal to determinant A into identity matrix of order n. This is very, very important result, and you must keep in your mind. Then you would be able to solve the problem of objective type questions from this chapter. A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A, and product will be determinant A and identity matrix. Now, I want to solve some problems on this concept. My dear students, some results are very, very important. If A and B are non-similar matrix of the same order, then AB and BA are also non-similar matrix of the same order.
when the matrix is said to be non-singular, if the determinant of a matrix is not equal to zero, then it is non-singular. And if determinant of a matrix is zero, then it is known as singular. So determinant of the product of matrices is equal to the product of their respective determinants. That is, determinant of AB is equal to determinant of A into determinant of B, where AB are square matrices of the same order. A square matrix A is said to be singular if determinant A is equal to zero. I have already discussed. A square matrix A is said to be non-singular if determinant A is equal to not zero. And this is very, very important theorem. Determinant of adjoint A. Determinant of adjoint A is equal to determinant of A to the power n minus 1. This is very, very important result, important theorem. You see, we have already just proved adjoint A into A is equal to determinant A into I. We have already proved earlier adjoint A into A is equal to determinant A into I. Now taking determinants both sides, the adjoint A, determinant of adjoint A into A is equal to matrix of determinant A. So it will be, and product of I, it will be determinant A 0, 0, 0 determinant A 0, 0, 0 determinant A. So now, determinant of adjoint A and A can be written separately. Adjoint A, determinant of adjoint A and determinant of A is equal to, by taking common, this is a determinant of order 3. So this is determinant A cube. We take common. And it will be adjoint A, determinant A, determinant A cube into I. So finally, adjoint A, determinant of adjoint A and into determinant A is equal to determinant A square. This is a very, very important result. In this way, you can make it general. Adjoint A into A is equal to determinant of adjoint A is equal to determinant of A to the power n minus 1. This is very, very important. You must remember it. So now, I want to discuss some more theorems. I hope you have understood this.